How are you? I hope that you will be fine. I am Aditya Vikram Rai from LPM Public School, and this school situated in Ghulam Bazar. On last day, we have learned different topics operating a computer. In this chapter, we have to learn starting a computer, parts of the desktop, shutting down a computer, and after that we have learned handling a mouse and touchpad. In this topic we have learned computer mouse, mouse axles, touchpad, eraser tool, fill with color tool, color picker tool, text tool, brushes tool, drawing sheets, saving a drawing, opening a saved drawing and closing pen. And now we are revising, and we have revised chapter 1, that is computer or smart machine. In this topic we have learned difference between humans and computers, types of computers and uses of computers at different places. And after that we have learned parts of a computer. In parts of a computer there are many parts, many main parts, that are monitor, CPU, keyboard and mouse. These are main parts of computer. And some additional parts also: printer, speakers, headphones and a microphone, UPS, hard disk, CD, DVD and pen drive. And we are revising operating a computer. In this chapter we have learned starting a computer. We know that computer is an electronic machine, but it is not switched on or switched off like any another electronic machine. There is a proper method to turn off a computer and turn on. You know that computer is an electronic machine, but it is not switched on or off like another electronic machine. There is a proper method to turn a computer on and off. We know that when we start a computer, we have to follow some steps to start a computer. In step first, you have to switch on the power supply button. In step 2, you have to turn on the uninterrupted power supply, UPS, that is called UPS. In step 3, you have to press the power button on the CPU box. And in step 4, you have to switch on the monitor. You can see here that in first step, the boy is switching on the power supply button. In step 2, the boy is turning on the uninterrupted power supply, UPS. And in third picture, the boy is pressing the power button on the CPU box. And in fourth picture, the boy is switching on the monitor. When a screen appears on the monitor, this screen is called a desktop. When computer is switched off, then a screen appears on the monitor. This screen is called a desktop. It indicates that a computer is ready to use. Info box, the process of starting a computer is known as booting. And the process of turning off a computer is called shutting down. Now, the next topic is parts of the desktop. There are some parts of desktop also. What are these? Icons. In first, icons. These are small pictures present on the desktop. And now, the taskbar, the long bar present at the bottom of the desktop is known as taskbar. This bar contains many icons. Start button. The start button is used to open any program on the computer. And now the topic is shutting down a computer. How we can shut down a computer? Let's learn. Turning off a computer directly from the main power button can harm you. If you turning off a computer directly from main power supply, that it can harm it and your computer can be damaged. Therefore, you must always follow the proper method. You must follow some proper method. These to shut down a computer. These are following. You know that turning off a computer directly from the main power button can harm it. That means if you turning off a computer directly from the main power supply button, that it can, the computer can, the you can damage your computer. Therefore, you must always follow the some proper method. to shut down a computer. How we can shut down a computer? Let's learn. In first step, you have to click the start button. Now in step 2, you have to press the power button appears. Click on it. And after that, the power button appears. Click on it. And in step 3, click on shutdown. Wait till the CPU switches off. Step 4, switch off the monitor. Step 5, turn off the UPS. Step 6, switch off the power supply button. Note, to keep the UPS charged, the main power supply button is generally kept on. Now, let's revise one time again. In first step, you can see here that you have to click the start button. And now after that, the power button appears. Click on it. And now, click on shutdown. Wait till the CPU switches off. In fourth picture, you can see here. In fourth picture, the boy is switching off the monitor. And in picture 5, the boy is turning off the UPS. And in step 6, the boy is switching off the power supply button. To keep the UPS charged, the main power supply button is generally kept on. Typewriter is the longest word that you can write using only the keys on the top row of a standard keyboard. Infobox, typewriter is the longest word that you can write using only the keys on the top row of a standard keyboard. In a standard keyboard, the keys of top row, you can write typewriter longest word from using top row of standard keyboard. Okay? Now, you have to come on the exercises. Some doubts here, you have to clear some doubts. Let's come on doubts. Take the correct answer. Which of the following appears on the screen after booting? You know that after booting, what is booting? Firstly, you have to know what is booting. The process of starting a computer is known as booting. Okay? And after booting, a screen appears on the monitor. This screen is called a desktop. It indicates that a computer is ready to use. So, there are three options: paint, desktop, notepad. So, the desktop is right option because you know that the process of starting a computer is known as booting. And after booting, a screen appears on the monitor. This screen is called a desktop. It indicates that a computer is ready to use. So, the option B is right option, that is desktop. Now, the next is, what does UPS stand for? A is used power stock. B is unwanted power supply. C is uninterrupted power supply. You know that the UPS stand for uninterrupted power supply. So the option C is right option. You know that there are three options: used power stock, unwanted power supply, uninterrupted power supply. So you know that the UPS stands for uninterrupted power supply. So you have to take option C. Option C is right option. And in question 3, which of the following is not a part of a desktop screen? You know that the desktop screen has two parts. The desktop screen has some part that are icons. These are small pictures present on the desktop. And taskbar, the long bar present at the bottom of the desktop, is known as taskbar. This bar contains many icons and start button. The start button is used to open any program on the computer. So you have to give in your option A, UPS, option B, taskbar, and option C, start button. You know that in desktop screen, icons, taskbar, and start button are presented. So there is not UPS. So you have to take right option is A, option A, UPS. And taskbar and start button presented on desktop screen, not UPS. So the option A is right option. In fourth, which of the following is the last step to turn on a computer? Which of the following is the
which of the following is the step to turn on a computer?
You know that on A, switch on the monitor, on B, press the main power supply, and C, switch on the UPS.
You know that for turning on a computer, in last step, you have to switch on the monitor. Okay? You know that in last step, you have to switch on the monitor. So the option A is right option. Okay? Which of the following is the last step to turn on a computer or switch on the monitor? Option A, switch on the monitor. This is right option. So you have to tick A. Now, you are, that's your homework time. You have to do, take the correct answer in your CW copy of chapter 3. And if you have not completed your copy up to chapter 2, then you have to complete it in your fair copy. Thank you.